All right, we're here at a unit where we know we've got a leak. We found it. So I'm going to test out the dye jug. This is the set of gauges I'm going to designate for this purpose. So let's get around here and see how this works. Okay, standing pressure 107, and we know we have a leak here because I had to top it off at the end of last year. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this dye jug that we made, and we're going to go from liquid only, and I did give it a little, a little shake in case it's not emulsified good. And I hate to bleed it here, but I'm going to try real easy. Yep, and I could see it was green. But like I said, these gauges are going to be dedicated to the dye situations. Okay, so I'm hoping we can see, in the sight glass when we turn some loose into the system. So I'm gonna go inside and turn it on first. Okay, so I'm gonna take the light. Yep, and we can see where I bled the hose, that's for sure. Nothing in the sight glass yet. So I'm going to turn it on and we're going to see if we can see it going in. All right, so for the moment I got my rag stuffed in it. Let's stop that terrible noise. Getting some heat off of it now. I'm not going to worry about an exact charge on this thing. I just want to get it back pumping and cooling well. Give it a week or a few days, whatever. It's only a couple of years old. See some dye in there even without the light. So this is part one, so I'm just going to save this footage, come back in a few days and take this little handy dandy trusty UV light, fluorescent light, whatever you want to call it. We're going to look around outside and inside and hopefully see some dye somewhere and show us what's happening and how to get this thing fixed. So I'm going to leave it just like that for now. Okay, so I only ran it in through the low side, but you can see when I took my hoses off, it's on both. The low and the high side. So 3 ounces to about 15 pounds of refrigerant was certainly enough to get it in the system. So let's come back in a couple of days and see what we find. Okay, it's been a couple of weeks. Probably actually about 19 or 20 days. Let's go take a look at this unit we charged with that dye jug we made and see if we can hopefully find the leak and see how well the particular concentration of dye we used is going to work. I tell you, it sure was convenient to put it in that way, but we're still on a learning curve. So let's take a quick look. We may have an outdoor leak here. Let's open this side door. Okay. That light off on the camera. All right, here we go. So I found one little joint right here. It's lighting up green. Don't know how well that's showing up on camera. In fact, I think it really isn't. Yeah, you can see it. So you can see that green dye. So let's go ahead and rub our finger across it. Oh yeah, there's some oil there too.